Welcome to a second example of determining the measure of angles based upon the properties of parallel lines. So here we have a diagram with two sets of parallel lines as well as a couple other transversals. We want to determine the measure of angle 1 through the measure of angle 7. Let's go ahead and label our parallel lines. Let's call this line L and this line M, this line P, and this line Q. So taking a look at angle 3 and the angle here that measures 107 degrees, these two are corresponding angles to line L and line M, and therefore they're congruent. So the measure of angle 3 would be 107 degrees. Angle 2 and angle 3 would be consecutive interior angles, or same side interior angles, which means they're supplementary. So the measure of angle 2 plus the measure of angle 3 must equal 180 degrees, which makes the measure of angle 2 73 degrees. Now the other angle they gave us was this angle here that measures 122 degrees. So looking at this angle here and this angle here with one hash mark, these would be consecutive interior angles, or same side interior angles, again with line L and line M cut by this transversal here. So these two angles are supplementary, so that means this angle here would have to be 58 degrees. Even though we don't have to determine the measure of this angle, notice that this angle is congruent with the measure of angle 1. So the measure of angle 1 is also 58 degrees. Now looking at the parallel lines P and Q, angle 1 and angle 4 are alternate interior angles and therefore congruent. So the measure of angle 4 is also 58 degrees. Now let's take a look at angle 6. Angle 6 and this angle here that measures 107 degrees are alternate exterior angles, where P and Q are the parallel lines and line L would be the transversal. So these two angles are congruent and therefore the measure of angle 6 is 107 degrees. Looks like we have angle 5 and angle 7 left. Notice that angle 5 and angle 7 would be alternate interior angles where P and Q are the parallel lines and this segment here would be the transversal. So if we can find one of them, we also know the measure of the other. There's a couple ways of doing this. Notice that again this angle here that measures 107 degrees would form a vertical pair with these two angles, which means the measure of angle 1 plus the measure of angle 5 must equal 107 degrees. And so we already know the measure of angle 1 is 58 degrees. We can determine the measure of angle 5 by taking 107 degrees and subtracting out 58 degrees. That's going to give us 49 degrees for the measure of angle 5 as well as the measure of angle 7. And that's going to do it for this example. I hope you found this helpful.